IVM.
TFG Football is an IVM production, and you can also check out their other awesome shows like The Seen and the Unseen, hosted by Amit Verma, where he discusses topics related to economic policies and its impact on our society.
You're listening to TFG Football.
Welcome everyone, it's a new episode of the TMZ New Football Podcast, and here we are at our respective homes today because of various reasons, and I have Kevin joining us back on the show, and virtually again, just the two of us, Sanjeev is still on the train, probably he'll be reaching home tonight, but Kevin, you're back, how have you been?
Oh yes, it was a relaxing time that I had, and all the while Indian football just keeps you interested, and life is just so good with I-League, ISL to some extent. I-League is always best, but yes, we are back. AFC Cup, it's AFC Cup time,
yeah.
And once again, Continental Championship just excites us to the highest level.
Yeah, absolutely, and we'll definitely come back to the AFC Cup match where Bengaluru FC begin their campaign against Transport United later today. But before that, we'll just talk about last night's match that we had in I-League. It was between Churchill Brothers and the NEROCA. Now, if you heard our show yesterday, Kiranji did say that Churchill was going to win. And it so happened that it was a 2-0 victory to Churchill Brothers. Kevin, it's a great transformation from Churchill, right? I mean, just to put out some stats that, you know, this guy for Aditya Varti on Twitter, he's an analyst, and he put after the match, he put out saying that Churchill have now collected 10 points from a possible 12 from their last 4 games, scoring 6 of their last 8 goals in the last 20 minutes. So they've been really good after, you know, being at probably 0 points and in the bottom of the table of the opening 5 games. So this is a great transformation for them.
Yeah, you know, when you look at Churchill Brothers, just the first half of the I-League this season, and you get an idea, so this team was even not ready to get off that bottom of the list, bottom of the table, and now look at them, they're climbing up, and soon enough I think they will be in mid-table and maybe probably challenging for the fourth place spot, and it is a transformation. But then if you look back what changed in this Churchill side, and the results that are being brought out with ease, if you can say that, it's the foreigners again. Just watch with the contribution of these foreigners to the Churchill Brothers team. They are just being able to get hold of all the problems Churchill had, and then again, it's not all foreigners who are being put out on the field. It's just some rotation, and it's an overall effort from both flanks. So we don't even see Nicolas Fernandez too often now, one of the best players that Churchill had in the first 3 or 4 games. That just goes to show you that the signings that they have made has just changed things around. And even yesterday, by the way, Indian Aerospace played, they weren't all bad. Indian Arrows, kept their shape well. One or two, chances where they could have created some trouble to the opposition. But for the final third is where they've been lacking all season. And now is a time where Indian Arrows are being treated how they should be. And that's the difficult part for Indian Arrows to, swallow. Now every team wants to get there. Whether it's the bottom side table or bottom side team or is a top side team, everybody wants to get all out because it's the second half of the season where nobody wants to lose points. So Indian Arrows will get some tough oppositions, and it just gets difficult for Matos.
Absolutely, but it is. I mean, like I mentioned yesterday on the show, the Indian Arrows also are the team when we thought when they would start, we felt like, they would be losing by 4 or 5 goals every game, but they are putting up competition which is making the other team, sweat and, say and not take them lightly. So it's a good competition on the field, and despite this loss, I'm sure they put up a great show. Now, moving on to some news from Kolkata. Now, yesterday, Sony Norde Mohun Bagan did his farewell for the season, because we called up for a press conference. Before that, he there were like fans flooding the mice and, you know, greeting him, giving him bouquets and, you know, just giving him a good farewell and hoping that he will come back strong and fit. So it was pretty emotional scenes over there, and for all those who watched the videos where he later on spoke to address the media as well and the fans, and he himself was pretty emotional. He actually broke down towards the end of it. And Kevin, no matter what we say, he is such a, he's brilliant to watch on the field, and I'm sure you feel for him because he has to leave the rest of, you know, the mid-season and to nurse an injury. So how, when you look at a player like that, how difficult is from a player's point of view to, you know, to leave a club that has given him so many memories and fans love him and all of that?
Yeah, this is more than professional now. This is an emotional connect that he's got with the fans, and vice versa. You know, fans do come out to the stadiums to watch their favorite players, and when their favorite players do go out to score and deliver according to what's expected of them, it's this, you know, worthwhile to be supportive of a club. And Sony Norde has been pivotal to Mohun Bagan's success. So every time Mohun Bagan have required somebody to step up, it's always been Sony Norde to one point of time, and being supported by obviously other players as well. But you know, deciding to stay after achieving success is, you know, it's a big decision. And Sony Norde, after getting success in the previous edition when they did win the I-League, I think that was crucial for the team and for the fans. That support, that core of the team had to stay intact. And he did deliver. And we've never seen a sloppy performance from him. It's been a bad day, you know, where you get close to the goal and your attempts are just flying over the bar or just missing your targets. Mm. It's never been someone who's just not being able to complete passes or simple one-to-one or maybe, you know, diagonal runs. So Sony Norde has been, you know, and I would say a picture of something that is a perfect player for fans. And that's why we see that emotional connect from him as well. You know, he has been glorified. Yeah. He has been supported. Yes, he's got his, you know, off days. But overall, if you could just see the time that he has in Mohun Bagan, I think he's one of the best performers that they've had. And seeing him, you know, forcefully, you know, it's not a decision that he's wanting to do, but he has to be forced to go away. And then he promises to come back. So that's just showing his, you know, the internal connection that he has with the club. That even though he might be unavailable for a certain time, he is promising to be back.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, when you, we'll definitely play out some clips for you, for our listeners here, where he's talking. And it was really touching where he said towards the end that, I mean, I'm definitely going to come back, and you know, once I'm fully fit, even if it's for free, I'll come back and play. I mean, for a player to say that, and that too of his caliber, you know how much it means. Yes, it's vice versa. I mean, the fans, you know, consider him as, like, so as a legend in Bagan, but for a player to come out and say, you know, it's more than, you know, it's definitely more than just football, right, Kevin?
Yeah.
I mean, things like these just.
Yeah, that's beauty of sport, beauty of football. It goes more beyond the field. It's always, you know, what you take home, what you're coming back for. So this is what we are, this is what the fans live for.
Yeah. Well, he's going to Argentina for the surgery, for the operation, and hopefully we wish him a speedy recovery and throughout his rehab. Here's some clip where he's addressing the media. Let's listen to him directly.
But I have to leave. I have to leave because for my career, for my future, for my family. Because if I stay here, like seeing Mohun Bagan play in a camp and kind of in a cup play, it would be not good for me. So I think the best thing is go, make myself fit and come to Mohun Bagan. These two guys, Tumpa and Devashis, in the street, they're calling me and that they are crying. I feel like they love me a lot, and only the way I can give them this love back, it's on the pitch. But from injury, I can't. So, as soon as possible. I be fit. I promise you guys, I come back very quickly to play for you, and even it's for free, I will come. But today in the day, it's not about me, it's about all Mohun Bagan, because Mohun Bagan is the national club in India. Day by day, they are proving. And yesterday, people can see that the way Mohun Bagan playing football. We supposed to score 6-7 goals yesterday, but so I hope and I will pray for you guys to keep winning. And whatever I stay, I will pray for Mohun Bagan win. And only I can say thank you very much. And if I skip speaking, I think I will cry more. So thank you very much for everything, and I will see you all very soon. Thank you.
Well, you heard the man, and I think most of the time, yes, he was pretty emotional. If you saw the videos, he was really crying, and he's bitterly crying, I must say, because towards the end, like he said, if you'll talk, he himself said that if I talk more, I think I'll continue crying, so I'll stop here. Some emotional scenes and great scenes from both fans and from Sony Norde. So just like I mentioned before, listening to him, that we wish him a speedy recovery, and hopefully we'll see him back again at his best, doing what he does best for whichever club, and he said he's coming back to Bagan, so we'll see him play in Bagan. It's time to slip in a short break. On the other side, we have, just like we started the show saying, we have the AFC Cup back again, and Bengaluru FC will take on their first match in the new season. All of that, we also have an I-League fixture, which Kevin will be eager to look at this time, because it's his team, Shillong Lajong, playing against NEROCA FC. All of that on the other side of the break.
Hi, I'm Amit Verma, the host of the weekly podcast, The Seen and the Unseen. In my show, I examine the seen effects and the unintended consequences of public policy and private action. I show how policies meant to help the poor often end up hurting the poor. I've done episodes so far on demonetization, GST, surgical strikes, immigration and MRP. And I will continue my forensic assault on the truth in the weeks to come.
Catch the show every Monday on the IVM podcast app or any other podcasting app that you prefer. Or visit seenunseen.in for all the latest updates.
Welcome back, guys. And once again, we will begin our talks on AFC Cup, because this particular team never stops performing well. They continue with their new heights, and once again, they are in the AFC Cup. It's a new season. New team that they have at the moment, and they will take on the Bhutanese side, Transport United, later today. And I think it's a 5:30 or 6 p.m. kickoff. It's going to be the first test for Bengaluru FC, but it looks like a relatively easy fixture for them. And they've sent, you know, if you look at their squad, there are no big names apart from Lenny Rodriguez, Lal Tumma, Vyaralte, who's going to lead this side. Stoney Devale and Alvin George. Now, there are also four players from the B side of Bengaluru FC. But the coach, Albert Roca, has put his trust in this youth young side and expects them to deliver. He also went on to say that we need to take advantage of squad depth. So, Kevin, it's the first game for them in the new season of AFC Cup campaign, giving some of the players a rest, because, yes, of course, I feel also the tedious fixtures that they have. What are you expecting from this match as they're playing away?
No, Siju, even before we talk about the match, what does this tell you about BFC as a club and its decision to have a calendar set and have a vision for, we always talked about vision for a club. So when you have simultaneous leagues to play for and you have the option of rotating players, so this is your decision point. Now, what is your aim? What do you want to achieve? And this is clear the way decisions are being made. I think they know where they are heading to. It's not in a haphazard manner. It's not, okay, let's see what happens tomorrow. Let's do something. They've already set a long-term plan, and this shows. Now, what kind of changes are we seeing in the squad? Now, this is a whole different squad from the one that has played the ISL. And it's not surprising to me that a club a young club like BFC, you know, they've achieved so much success, and it is because of this vision. I hate to say this when Chiranjit is not there. It's about Bagan, obviously. You've seen Bagan struggle when they had to play the AFC Cup and they had to play the I-League and the Federation. Everything was together last season. No, it was all cramped. Same set of players were being played over and over again. Few rotation. And that just hit them. No, injuries came along. And then they lost track of which direction they were heading. Because it was all, trying to put all your eggs in different baskets and then expect them to, hatch all together. It's not going to happen that way. You need to be focusing, okay, what is your best foot and where do you take it? And, BFC has done it right, I feel. Just look at the squad selection. They know exactly, they've studied the opponent. It's not, should we go ahead with the best team, should we not? They put a balanced side. They've got players in certain positions who can be leaders in their place. And that's just commendable from BFC. It's for me, it's the vision. It's not even this one game that I'm looking at. They know what they want in this season, and they've worked really hard towards that.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, this is a preliminary stage, and it's a preliminary round six church, an away match, and I think the home leg is on 30th of January, so I think if they can make the most out of this away fixture, playing at the fortress has always been lucky for Bengaluru. But to give us something about Transport United, the Bhutanese club, they've been the champions of the Bhutan National League, and the 2017 season they had an unbeaten run. It's the first time that they're playing in the AFC Cup. So it's going to be a crazy one where a two-time semi-finalist and one-time finalist are playing a debut team. Debutant in the AFC Cup campaign with a relatively probably second string, but then as just like Albert Roca is saying, it's time that we put them to test and they need to step up as their responsibility is given. So a lot of interesting things there. I mean, to also another point, another fact, Bhutan is apparently the 13th country, that 13th different country that the Bengaluru will travel to play in Asian competition. So it's since the debut in 2015, so it's pretty interesting to see that. And now, Kevin, coming to you, we've seen teams that travel to the northeast with high altitude and temperatures dropping, probably how difficult the situation is. The same looks like in Bhutan, because the temperature might just drop to, in the evening, it drops to 2 to 6 degrees and all of that. So the high altitude, so how do you think that would play out for the Bengaluru FC side?
The weather conditions obviously do play a big role in the performance of your players, but it's not that they've not been to similar conditions. BFC are well aware of the climatic conditions, and that must have been surely taken into consideration for the preparation of the game. And I did meet the team the next day. They were heading to the airport, so that's when it struck me, okay, so Bhutan is the next country they headed to. And it's a great journey for such a young club, being able to be playing at so many different levels. It just gives you, it just adds experience to your bag, playing at different weather conditions and a different setup. And it's going to be a test both ways. But it's going to be a tactic, because it's an away game, obviously. You don't want to lose points. So probably even a small margin victory will do. But since this team is fairly new, playing together, I think Roca might just try to squeeze out as many possible goals from this game, just to avoid any difficulty back home.
Yeah, absolutely. So, is that what you're calling? Do you have a definite, do you have a precise number that you're looking at, the number of goals?
It's tough. It's always tough to play an away game under difficult climatic conditions. So, we've not seen this team play together. So, it's tough to call how they might approach. But one thing is for sure, I think the back line will be more solid. They won't be that as much as fluid that we might expect them. Because against a team that is, that's been unbeaten at one point of time, obviously they possess a good attacking threat. So you don't want to leave your back line, you know, too fluid to be exposed to an attacking side. So I see a tight game at the back. Probably the midfield shuffles less often than we've seen BFC do. It's going to be good to look at how the formation is set up at the kickoff.
Right. I mean, probably we'll end the discussion with what Albert Roca said towards the end of the press conference, I guess. He said that he wants the fans of both the sides, especially, to just enjoy the match, sit back and, you know, have a great game, because we don't know what to expect from this game. It's like you mentioned, with the new side who are playing together, and also, you know, we don't know much about Transpiri Madra as well. So, but you can expect a good game, that's what he mentioned, and we are all expecting and hoping for the same. Let's see how that goes about. You can follow the TFG Football to the handle for all the updates about the game and whatever is happening in Bhutan. Now, moving on to the other fixture that we have, it's an early kickoff. Probably by the time the show is out, the match must be kicked off by then. But it's NEROCA versus Shillong, and Kevin, I mean, when you missed out during the weekend, I'm sure you must have had a look at it. Shillong lost their game against Churchill Brothers, and meanwhile, NEROCA extended their unbeaten run to 9 matches, beating the defending champions Aizawl, and they look in terrific form. And here they are now hosting Shillong Lajong. I know, Kevin, how do you feel about...
I feel lost already. Package? I feel lost. Just looking at... I was greeted by, you know, a big picture of Churchill beating Shillong in one of the newspapers, and just it hit me, okay, that is the reality. Churchill are coming back, and Shillong Lajong are no longer showing the form that they had shown at the start of the season. So Shillong Lajong really, you know, have been lost in transition here. They just don't seem to be the team that was, you know, looking so promising at the start. So against a side like NEROCA, what can you expect? But just remember the time that Shillong Lajong was able to get out that vital point against Mohun Bagan, and nobody expected them to do that. So probably, you know, it's a game where NEROCA struggled to get past an okay side of Shillong Lajong, and Shillong Lajong are able to keep that clean sheet or probably end up in a 1-1 draw. This could be party spoilers, Shillong Lajong, no, that way. I'm not seeing Shillong Lajong going anything close to a strong performing team like NEROCA at this time. They just want to, you know, get back to that one-pointer game before they can come out and play other teams where they can expect to go, can expect to win all 3 points. But against NEROCA, I think it's going to be tough for them to manage this fluid attack that they have, you know, especially in the midfield. I think Aaron Williams is the one who's dictating all the play, and if there's any way to stop him, Subhash Singh is there. You know, they just they're never short of options to attack.
Yeah, and also their Turkovic, who's been a clinical finisher and a match winner for them, always comes at the right time to score and, you know, takes the 3 points for NEROCA. So, yeah, just like you mentioned, all these names just make you think, oh, NEROCA is going to take it. So, I mean, that's what it comes down to. I mean, they've been such terrific performance at the moment. Well, let's see, how many goals are you looking at?
I'm looking at a 1-1, very strongly looking at 1-1. But I won't be surprised if you know, the floodgates open and it goes to 3-1 to NEROCA.
Oh, okay. Well, let's see if NEROCA can, you know, continue their unbeaten run. And this would be their 10th match unbeaten if they manage to beat Shillong Lajong later today. Well, let's see how that goes. And pretty interesting action coming your way with the AFC Cup and the I-League fixtures for both. You can follow the TFG Football to handle. Get on the website, thefangraphs.com, to check it out. And if you've enjoyed this show, then please show us some love by liking, sharing and subscribing to our YouTube channel. Let us know your thoughts about all of that we spoke today in our comment section below. If you want to talk to us directly, you can do that. Kevin's the handle is Boza_Kevin, CGMatthew94. Join us on the train, where you can catch him on Twitter at Chiranjit Oja. Have a great day, folks. Enjoy these matches and come back to us tomorrow. Cheers.
As you can see, we have a podcast listener in his natural habitat. Millions of years of evolution have led him to this point. He's on his way to work, and listening to podcasts makes his miserable day better. He will now head to work and use all his knowledge to communicate with other colleagues and possibly future mates. You can find more of his species on ivmpodcasts.com, your one-stop destination where you can check out all the coolest Indian podcasts. Happy listening.